Hi there, Spark fans. Rob Reynolds here with some big news about a small board. In fact, this board is smaller than small. I'd even go as far as to say it's teensy. That's right. You know it. You love it. I know I sure love it. And now the latest version has been released. Introducing the Teensy version 4.1. Now, this amazing board has a list of incredible specs longer than a CVS receipt. So I'm going to give you a moment to grab a drink, maybe get a snack, and get comfortable because this could take a while. We'll start with the processor. The Teensy 4.1 has an ARM Cortex-M7 running at 600 MHz. There's 1024K of RAM, 512K of which is tightly coupled. It has 8 MB of flash memory, which, for those of you keeping score at home, is 4 times as much as was on the Teensy 4.0. The underside of the board has locations to solder on 2 additional memory chips, one for PSRAM and the other for flash. There are 55 total I/O pins. Among them, there are 3 CAN bus pins, one of which offers CAN-FD, 2 I2S digital audio pins, 1 SPDIF digital audio pin, 1 4-bit native SD, plus 3 spy pins, all with 16-word first in, first out. There are 7 bottom SMT pad signals, along with 8 serial ports, 32 general DMA channels, 18 analog inputs, and 35 PWM pins. As laid out, 42 of the I/O pins are breadboard friendly. Whew!
Let's all go to the lobby. Let's all go to the lobby. Let's all go to the lobby to get ourselves a treat.
Okay, we're back. Continuing on, the Teensy 4.1 offers cryptographic acceleration, a random number generator, and a real-time clock for maintaining date and time even when the Teensy is powered down. It also offers programmable flex I/O, pixel processing pipeline, and peripheral cross-triggering. Additionally, there are 6 pins to allow you to add 10 100 Mbit DP83825 PHY Ethernet, a microSD card socket, and power on-off management. When running at 600 MHz, the Teensy 4.1 consumes approximately 100 milliamps of current and provides support for dynamic clock scaling. Unlike traditional microcontrollers, where changing the clock speed causes wrong baud rates and other issues, Teensy 4.1 hardware and Teensy Duino software support for Arduino timing functions are designed to allow dynamic speed changes. So serial baud rates, audio streaming sample rates, and Arduino functions like delay and millis, plus Teensy Duino's extensions like interval timer and elapsed millis, continue to work properly while the CPU changes speed. That is crazy! The one thing the Teensy 4.1 does not have is headers. So if you want to do some breadboarding with it, you'll need to get those and solder them in yourselves. Now, I would have loved to have made an amazing project with this board, but truth be told, I got it this morning, and there was no way I was going to be able to demonstrate its capabilities in that amount of time. I would have felt like I was underrepresenting the board and cheating you, and frankly, I feel like you deserve better than that from me. So don't wait for me, go out and grab your own Teensy 4.1 now, and start building bigger, stronger, faster projects with this amazing little 2.5 by 3/4 inch wonder board. Pick up yours over at sparkfun.com, and happy hacking! Hi there, Spark fans. Oh, I have a question about this. Oh, I'll ask you later. Sometimes I distract myself. Now, I would have loved to have made a project. Made in a project? That's not right. That's not how sentences work. How do I say that word? Acceleration? Okay, here we go. I'm back. So, where was I? There I am. I may have taken intermission too early. Oh yeah, we have to go all the way back because we're shooting my face. Okay,